Whoa, that was close. Glad no one saw that. That was almost embarrassing and painful. I'll admit it, I was walking distracted. But so what? I'm a good multitasker, and I like getting the most out of every moment. It's not against the law, yet. In Hawaii, it is against the law to cross the street while using your phone. They call it the zombie walking law. Oh. In bigger cities like Toronto, there's over 1,700 collisions between pedestrians and vehicles in 1 year. Turns out, walking hazards are everywhere. So today I've set up a walking course. Lavina, I'm hoping you can help me out. I'll send you through the walking course once, just as you normally would down the street, and then I'll send you through again using your phone, see if there's any differences. Sound good?
Yeah.
The large pylons represent a street, so I'm just gonna get you to walk this course like you're walking down the street. So look both ways, avoid the obstacles in the middle, and make your way out the back. Okay. Sound good? We'll do it once without the phone, okay. And then we'll do it once with the phone to see if anything changes.
Okay.
All right, I'll time you as well.
Okay.
So I'll count you down here. 3, 2, 1, go. All right, making it through no problem. Avoided the obstacles. Very good. Simple, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what I'm gonna get you to do is, I'll get you to send me a text message.
Okay.
A nice long one, you know what I mean? I'm gonna rearrange those obstacles in the middle, but let's just see if your walk changes at all.
Okay.
Okay. I'm gonna put nothing at the beginning, make two hard ones at the end. Now, I'm not asking you to walk without any care and attention, but definitely keep your eyes on the phone, see if you can use your peripheral vision and make your way through the course. If you feel in danger at all, peek up, go ahead.
Okay.
I think the point here is to see if your walk changes at all while you're using your phone.
Okay,
same thing, I'll count you down.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, go. Okay, she's already walking slower. Oh, whoa, big wide turn. So she does know the course, but. No obstacles yet, no obstacles yet. Okay, two big ones. So always hanging on the wide turns. It seems like didn't quite notice till the very end. Time. Okay, test complete. How do you think it went?
That was harder than I thought it would be. I didn't really see anything until I was almost on top of a pylon before I could know that I needed to move out of the way. And the ground definitely, I was more aware of it being uneven.
Well, you were definitely slower. It went from 20 and a half seconds to 30 and a half seconds.
Really?
So it definitely took you a little bit longer. What I noticed is that the first time without the phone, you cut corners, you were taking the quickest path through.
Right.
And then with the phone, it kind of took you hitting the edge of the course to turn around.
Okay, well, I'd love to see you do it.
Well, I guess I could. I was trying to.
Drop the GoPro on him, let's do it,
yeah.
Come on.
So, was that as easy as you thought it would be?
Okay, definitely not. When I was doing the course, I noticed I was paying a little bit more attention at one point, but then I looked down at my phone and I was just typing the word H, or the letter H over and over again. So in order for me to pay attention, I had to like stop texting you. As soon as I resumed texting you, right back to using my peripheral vision, not knowing exactly where the quickest route would be, I knew exactly what was coming, but I couldn't fight it basically.
Right, so it makes me wonder if it really is as easy as we think it is to walk and text.
Well, I think we just showed you it can be done, but you're definitely sacrificing speed, balance. Basically, you don't walk like a normal person would walk. I'm kind of surprised because I set that course up and I, figured I just knew it in the back of my mind. But I didn't, I guess.